home to the Alamo and the Spurs. San Antonio, Texas, as we bring you an interconference rivalry here at the AT&T Center. Welcome, everyone, to NBA Basketball here on 2K Sports. Tonight, it's Noche NBA, a celebration of the amazing Latin culture in this league and its fans all around the globe. A great tradition we get to enjoy. Kevin Harlan here alongside Greg Anthony and Chris Webber. D.A. David Aldridge is on our sideline. Taking a look at Baltimore. They're hungry for wins and have to look at this as a great chance. Facing another struggling team, we'll see if they can seize the opportunity.
And it's the last time they'll see these guys. A two-game season series, and after losing that first one, I'd expect them to play with a little extra added motivation.
They want this win bad. Trust me, whenever you're playing a team four times or just twice, you never want to get swept.
Now the starting group for Baltimore. DeMarcus Cousins out there with Michael Porter. Then there's Bogdanovich. Then there's Bell. And it's Ball in at the point. Now here's Bogdanovich. After the miss from Derek White. And stolen by White. About 1 minute into the first quarter. He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, I did speak with the Barons head coach. Going into the game, he knows DeMar DeRozan will go to his pet move time and time again. Coach said he's so consistent. You prepare for him to drive the ball, then pull up, but you still can't stop it in real life. So they'll just do what they do and hope that it's enough to slow him down. Kevin?
Thanks, David.
And if you go over the course of his career, DeRozan has increased his trips to the line. I mean, thanks in large part to getting more aggressive offensively.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good. Greg, too early to start talking about MVP for this year or midseason?
We've gotten to a point now where we start talking MVP at the start of the season, you know?
Yeah, right.
People just love to talk sports at this point, especially when it comes to the most prestigious individual awards out there. I think you can make a case and sway some opinions with your play this time of year, but I like to let it all play out before I start focusing on that.
Things can change in a hurry, can't they, in a season?
Yes, they can.
Like you say, let it play out. Here's Cousins, and he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
For a bigger guy, Cousins possesses such a nice touch. 270-pounder plus with finesse. Not easy.
And Young kicks to Šarić. Outside Conley. 6 on the shot clock. A 17-footer. DeRozan. That's good.
And this has really always been a staple of his game. You see how confident DeRozan is with that mid-range.
Now here's Porter. Outside Ball. And what a play. Just snatched out of the air. Credit the block. Passes it to Young. Uncovered. Cousins pulls it in. And so Cousins will bring it up for the Barons. They trail by one. And the shot is good.
Amazing floor awareness from Cousins. Skilled at spotting the open man.
White against Bogdanovich. Conley inside the line. Here's Šarić, and good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. Guys, no one team gaining control early on.
Yeah, and you look at the lead changes. 6 already.
It's Bogdanovich on the wing. Back to Ball. Outside Bogdanovich. Fires the 3. No good. Now San Antonio takes it the other way. Porter against Conley. clock at 6. And Bogdanovich picks up the foul. That's his first foul. How about that strong defensive performance for this half's mobile one block?
And early in a game, these sorts of plays really can set the tone.
And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played, on the wing, DeRozan cans the shot from the wing. DeRozan's got 6.
Oh, the floor's general skills of Conley. I mean, he has a fantastic feel for when his teammates need the rock.
And you watch DeRozan play, he still has that explosiveness. Great first step out of the triple threat position. Can switch directions on the go. Is still a handful to slow on the perimeter.
And the Spurs with possession following the bucket by Baltimore. Now here's Conley outside White. 5 on the clock. DeRozan for 3. Sinks the three-pointer. He's got 9. Craig, with the explosiveness you talked about with DeRozan, it helps that he finishes so well when he gets to the rim.
And maybe not what he once was, but he is still an elite-level athlete. Doesn't only have to drop the hammer when he gets to the rim either. Very smooth at adjusting mid-flight to finish at the rim.
Porter with a block.
And, you know, as he learns the game at this level, he's going to block more shots. Porter has the length and the ability to move his feet.
Buries it from three-point range. Bogdanovich has got his second basket of the game.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Okay now, Conley.
Outside Conley. And the call will be against LaMelo Ball. That's his first foul. And so it's San Antonio with it. No one near Conley as he lets it go. And good as it just snugs right down through the net.
The handles of Conley, sick. I mean, he knows how to put on a display with his ball control when he wants to.
Ball, the pass to Cousins. That's tipped. Just 5 to shoot.
Playing soft off him, he might have been better off taking it to the hoop instead of settling for the jumper.
Here's DeRozan. Bell with the block.
Gotta respect the competitive nature of Bell. Terrific at playing with energy on defense and swatting shots away. And when you think about it, Thaddeus Young, he could be a thorn in the opposition side. He's just a great disruptor on defense. I mean, he has long arms, good timing to get those deflections.
Shooting 2.
That free throw missing.
And with Young, I mean, his game has evolved over the course of his career.
Oh, think about it, G.A. When he came into the league, he was an up-and-down tweener. I think what's made him more consistent of a player you can rely on, is his defense has improved, and along with his shooting. Now, he uses different methods, but he still gets it done as a vet.
And the second free throw, good. And Morris has got the ball here for the Barons. 4-point game. Pass to Porter. Over Conley, Porter's trying to free himself. Porter, no luck.
That's a break for the D right there. I mean, he takes advantage of open looks inside more often than not.
And Fournier gets to Conley. Near the three-point line, it's Porter. The step-back jumper is good. Porter's got his second bucket of the night.
A high-level level athlete with great run and jump ability. Porter finishes well in transition.
Let's it fly. Once again off the mark by San Antonio.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
3-on-3. Johnson goes in. Pass to Morris. Evans kicks to Porter. Baltimore moving that ball around. Morris outside. Just 5 on the clock. Baltimore needs to get off a shot here. But they'll get another chance. Here's Portis. That misses. Had a chance to tie it there. Well, for Baltimore, their last game, a loss to the Hornets in Charlotte.
Conley.
And it's sent back by Morris. Here's Roby. It's good. This game is all even. And here's Fournier.
Timeout.
Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game. They defeated the Wizards in their last game.
And really showed their depth when they needed it most. On the road, having to manufacture points.
The bench did exactly what they needed to do. Without their production, who knows if they win that game.
Spurs making a switch here. Sumanich is checked in. And a switch here also for Baltimore. Martin's checked in. Here's Fournier. And the layup falls. And the Spurs lead by 2.
Just focusing on the task at hand, that's all you can do.
Oh, you know what it is. One play at a time. That's got to be the mindset, especially in such a tight game.
Morris with the bucket.
How about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
Here's Conley. Lock at 6. For 3. Baltimore with the rebound. Shot by Evans. Nobody around. Connects from three-point range. And now a three-point Barron lead. Conley kicks to Plumlee. The pass to Samanich. Outside Conley. Passes it to Fournier. Goes up on the wing. It's rebounded by Portis. Baltimore leading by 3. This offense has really been clicking.
And they know it, guys. They're playing right now with the kind of energy that is hard to deal with.
Now here's Conley. Pass to Fournier. Back to Conley. From the baseline. Unable to get that one. And Baltimore going the other way now.
This quarter has been hit or miss for him. Mostly miss.
Roby the pass to Morris. Off target with his 3. And so it's Johnson who brings the ball up for San Antonio. They trail by 3. And Fournier kicks to Johnson. .152 left here in the opening quarter. For First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Not the best statistic for him in terms of his performance at the line. Very low numbers.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he can't get the first one. A lot of great talkers over the years. Trash talkers on the floor in this league. Do you think they do it more to get themselves going, Greg? Or do they do it with the purpose of getting under their opponent's skin?
And, Kevin, that's a great question, and believe it or not, you see both. I've seen guys who do it to get under your skin, and I've also seen guys that do it for their own benefit. That's how they derive their confidence. And so it's about you figuring out what works for you. I've seen some guys, they don't say smack. They don't say a word during the course of the game, but they will cut your heart out. So it's just about what fits your personality in terms of making you play your best.
Well, I'm glad you don't trash talk here on 2K, Greg. I'll tell you that right now.
No, we don't do that.
Here's Morris following the basket by Evan Fournier. Pass to Evans. Pulls it from 20 and misses it off the right side of the rim.
He makes a lot more of those than he misses. Not sure what threw him off right there.
The pass to Plumlee. Outside Fournier. Stolen by Evans. Now running up the court, Evans trying to push it up. From down in the low post, it goes. Evans has got five.
Way ahead of the field. He can do pretty much whatever he wants.
Yeah, and defensively, you'd like to see a greater effort to change ends.
Plumlee, the pass to Zizic. Fournier against Morris. Five to shoot. Here's Fournier. It's blocked.
Gotta have more of this moving forward. Portis has the size needed to turn back shots.
Sixteen seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Here's Morris.
Tendi.
Passes it to Portis. Got a piece of it. And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Barons lead by two. Live from the AT&T Center in San Antonio, you're watching 2K Sports. Welcome back, everyone. It's Noche Latina in the NBA as we resume action. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen so far, guys, from the Barons.
Well, this is the edge that great rim protection can give you.
Showing no mercy right now. The shooters look frustrated, seeing so many of their shots get stifled.
Here's Ball. He's been patient so far, nothing on the scoreboard yet. And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. On the floor for Baltimore, we've got Evans. He's out there with Ball. Martin is out there with Portis. And it's Roby in at the power forward position.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
Baltimore shooting their first shots of the night from the charity stripe.
Thank you.
first one falls for. Baltimore making a switch here. Cousins is checked in. And both free throws good for Evans.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
Now White pass to Simonich. Johnson surveying the floor. A three-pointer off the mark. Baltimore leading by four. Martin dishes to Cousins. White against Ball and stolen by White. Pass to Johnson. It's Fournier on the wing. It's White on the wing. Defended by Portis. Kept alive. Outside Ball with a floater. Baltimore moving that ball around. Here's Portis. It's blocked and he recovers it and he gets it back. Ball no good. Spurs trail by four. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Here's Fournier. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Yeah, the defender all over.
So many people know your story. Born and raised in Las Vegas. It must have been an amazing feeling then to lead UNLV to its only championship.
I mean, Kevin, you know, playing in front of so many people you know has its pros and cons.
Right.
But to be a part of that 1990 championship team and the only
Take
one we've been able
Take
to hoist and to have Two my shot. Jersey hanging in that rafter, it's humbling and, yes, it brings back a lot of fond memories.
Like historically good, right? When you think of that team, what that meant, it has a historic place.
It does. We felt like we were able to etch our mark in terms of the lures of the game of college basketball.
Sharj checked in for San Antonio. DeRozan comes in for Johnson. And then for the Barons, Bally's checked in for Portis. And it's Bogdan Bogdanovic in for Martin. He hits the second from the line. Second quarter, we're a little over a minute and a half in. Baltimore leading by three.
Tight D, tight D.
Ball feeling it out a bit. Bell with it. Down to five on the shot clock. And it's blocked. And it's going to be out of bounds. Baltimore will retain possession. And we're about 2 minutes into the second quarter here.
He's cooled down a little bit after draining those 2 3-pointers in the first quarter. His shot's just, it's not there right now. With his team leading, perhaps, you know, let's focus on some other areas of the game.
And here's Ball. He'll bring it up for Baltimore. They've only given up 1 point in the second quarter. That one coming at the line.
Cousins is a straight-up bully in the paint. A master at drawing contact, thanks to his size.
And he's got his first free throw of the game.
DeMarcus Cousins, two shots.
And the first one drops.
Oh, what makes Cousins successful? You have to be willing to challenge people night in and night out at both ends on the floor.
So he hits one of two from the stripe.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
Charge outside. Outside, White. And the foul on Jordan Bell. That's his first foul. Michael Porter, he's checked in for Baltimore. Second quarter of play with almost 3 minutes gone. Right the pass to Zizic. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
And finally, someone scores.
Yeah, this is low output for both teams. This is ugly. The defense is having their way so far.
Porter looking it over. Knocked loose and stolen by Fournier. And here we go with DeRozan running it up the middle. Now here's White. He is still scoreless so far in this one. Fournier's shot is off.
And I think that one could have easily have fallen for him.
Here's Porter. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. That one on White.
Yeah, a former five-star recruit. We know about the talent level with Porter, but he's also a mature, hard-working guy.
Baltimore shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game. Throw good, Porter. And Porter drops them both. Greg is a broadcaster. Who have been some of your favorite personalities to cover?
Man, that's a great question. You know, most of the stars, I'm a big fan of Durant and Steph and LeBron and those guys. Chris Paul's another one that's a favorite. So many other guys, you know, there's so much more personality and so much more confidence these guys have working in front of the camera. I think that just makes for a better experience.
Somebody asked me the other day, who is my favorite? You know who I said?
Who was that?
Greg Anthony.
Oh, you're just saying that because it's true.
Oh, the body control of Cousins knows how to get hit and still finish off the shot.
Spurs trail by four. Outside Fournier. Back to White. Now the pass to Zizic. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
Not quite enough defense that time around. Just lucky he was off.
Fournier goes in, and he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
Those plays can make a difference in a game like this.
Well, you know it's going to fire up, Greg, everybody on that bench.
And rightfully so. Also, how lackluster was the defense right there with the score this tight?
No good from Cousins.
Oh, you hate to let those easy chances slip through your fingers.
Outside, White. It's blocked. And here's Porter. 6 points for him. Knocks down the three ball. Porter's got the lead up to five now for Baltimore.
And you already see the great range, a calling card of Porter's, even back in high school, shot 47% as a senior.
DeRozan's shot is good.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Ball, the pass to Cousins. And Bell kicks the ball. Inside, here's Cousins. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball. Cousins has got his third basket of the night.
Overpowering strength and athleticism. Cousins is a handful to deal with around the rim.
San Antonio calls timeout.
As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Different look now for San Antonio. Thaddeus Young, he's checked in for Zizic. And Mike Conley is subbed in for White. It's Fournier on the wing.
And being that close to the hoop, I thought he had enough room to finish that one.
Spurs trail by five. Oh, that's blocked.
Well, you couldn't ask for a harder worker than Bogdanovich. It takes a lot of effort to cover a shot that well.
Ball dishes to Porter. Ball with it, and Young picks him up defensively. Ball, the pass to Cousins. Up top, Porter. Ball with a wide open look. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. And now a 7-point Baltimore lead. And so it's Conley bringing up the ball for San Antonio. Šarić passes to Young. Conley kicks to Šarić. And then Šarić slams it in.
And Kevin, even though they're down, he's still looking to do the spectacular. And he did.
Well, maybe this is the best time to do it. For San Antonio, they have shot 5 of 8 from the foul line. Mason Plumlee's checked in for San Antonio. Then for Baltimore, Roby's checked in, and Morris subbed in for Bogdan Bogdanovic.
One shot.
And that one falls from Šarić. Here's Ball. Passes to Porter. Over Young. Porter, no luck. Spurs trail by 4. Here's Young. It's tipped. Outside, Ball. Tipped away. Porter passes the ball. In the corner, it's Morris. 6 to shoot. Takes a 3. Rejected by Young. And he's able to get it back.
Nothing seems to be going down for him today.
And here are the Spurs. And it's Conley penetrating. And here's the fast break. Ball leading the way. Porter outside. Rebound San Antonio. Šarić has got his 5th rebound in this one. Here's DeRozan. And DeRozan throws it down.
When you want to talk about high volume scores, just look at what DeRozan's doing tonight. He's been on a mission, putting his mark on this game in a big way.
Now, here is Bell. To Morris. Shoots over DeRozan. Again the miss by Morris.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
Yeah, he just hit a rough patch. He's trying to climb out of it, but hasn't been successful.
Conley finds DeRozan. Šarić trying to break free. That ties it up. DeRozan's got 15 points.
and they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Outside, Porter. Baltimore moving that ball around. Morris passes to Porter. They could use a bucket. That's good on the jump shot. Porter's got 7 points for the quarter.
And out of the pick and roll, Porter showing great coordination, fluidity, and versatility.
Plumlee, the pass to Šarić. To the inside, to Rowe. Look at him!
And that's the athleticism. When DeRozan takes off like that, he is looking to ring the bell.
So timeout called here, the first for the Barons.
Trying to find some answers offensively.
Bad shot selection, as well as some bad luck. I mean, that's not going to help you score points.
Some changes here for the Spurs. Šumanić just checked in, and it's Johnson in for Thaddeus Young. Now Morris. Pass to Martin. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by DeRozan. Here's Morris, drains the 19-footer. Morris has got his second basket. Enzo Conley will bring the ball up for the Spurs. Trailing by two, poked loose, and stolen by Portis. Morris dishes to Evans, and there's the pass to Portis. Morris outside. 6 on the shot clock. Rebound, San Antonio. DeRozan's got 5 rebounds tonight.
And gotta like what they've been doing down low in the post.
And it's Šumanić missing. Over to the left wing. And that one's good by Roby. 1:31 left in the first half. Outside Conley. Here's DeRozan. But he gets it back. Baltimore with the rebound.
Look, they say there are no easy finishes in the NBA, but that should have been easy.
In the corner, it's Morris. Pass to Roby. Second shot opportunity, and it's in after a nice bounce off the right side. Roby's got 6.
And without looking at the scoreboard, you think they were the team trailing and trying to fight their way back.
Down low, Plumlee, and it's slammed in by Plumlee.
And some hang time on the rim. Puts a little cherry on the top of that slam.
Well, those kind of displays of strength can get one team rolling. Now, here is Morris. Outside, Martin. Pass to Portis. His 3-pointer's off the mark.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
And Plumlee kicks to Johnson. Here's the floater. Morris outside. Ball's knocked loose. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. And with that shot, the Baron lead is cut down to 2 on the bucket from Conley.
And that's such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Barons ahead, up 2. And we'll be back right after halftime for the start of the third quarter. We'll see you in a bit.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back from the first half. Been a dandy so far. A dandy. You like that word, Kenny?
You know
what?
It's
a dandy.
My third grade teacher used to say that all the time.
That you're a dandy.
So this is a dandy of a class.
It is. And this is a dandy of a show. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet, Shaquille O'Neal.
So what's a dandy lion?
Well, basically, that's what the class was.
A really cool lion.
Got it.
Well, for Baltimore, Kenny, give us your take.
Well, we can't look past the work that their reserves have done tonight. There was a big difference between the teams in terms of points off the bench. And that could be a big factor in close games. When you can lean on your bench for offense, it's a nice advantage.
Shaq, what did you see from San Antonio?
When you think about giving up 3 or 4 extra turnovers, that can mean 8 or 9 points at the other end. That's why every coach preaches it. Take care of the basketball. Bottom line, they need to protect the ball and play under control.
And that wraps up the halftime show. Third quarter set to begin in just a few.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. A fantastic game from DeMar DeRozan so far.
Man, he's been running wild on him through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
And as they can't slow him down, you know what you do? Keep feeding them and feeding them and feeding them. This is the right game plan.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. They've got Young. White is out there with Conley. Then it's DeRozan, and it's Šarić in at the 5 roaming the paint. That's the San Antonio 5. Now here's Cousins. And it's Bogdanović in the corner. Shot clock at 5. Off target from 3-point range. San Antonio trailing here. Here's Young. And that one falls, coming off Conley's feet. Conley's got 4 assists now tonight. So it's the Barons now. Outside ball. Feeds it to Porter. At the elbow, it's Cousins. Šarić grabs the board. Šarić has got rebound number 7 for him tonight. DeRozan with it. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
And that's an aggressive take there by DeRozan. And no doubt the coaches will appreciate his ability to attack the defense.
They now lead as the free throw drops for him. Both free throws good from DeRozan. And if you're just joining us, we played over a minute here in the third. Pass to Cousins. And here's Bell. Outside ball. And the pass to Cousins. Over Young. No good from Cousins.
But this is not the start they wanted coming out of the break. 0 for 3 so far, and they're not playing with much intensity.
So it's the Barons now. A two-point game.
Open your eyes!
And the officials call a traveling violation.
And those are the kinds of mistakes that are magnified when we're talking about a game down the stretch.
A tremendous Mobile One block that we had to see again. Great send back.
Close games can boil down to who makes plays on defense, and that is one heck of a rejection right there.
Well, they're really making a point of keeping the ball moving around.
That's the key. The D can't focus on one player, and no matter what anybody tells you, that ball will always move quicker than the defender.
Poked away, stolen by Ball. Makes it off the glass. Ball's got the game tied up here for the Barons.
Finally, they get one to drop. That's one of their first four here in the third.
Passes it to Conley. All sorts of time, and all around the rim that time before dropping in. Conley's got eight.
Oh, man, the timing, the precision. Conley is ready to fire as soon as the ball hit his hands.
Pass to Cousins. Back to Ball. And Derek White picks up the foul. That's foul number two for him. Evan Fournier is checked in for DeMar DeRozan.
Your Spurs, Evan Fournier.
Ball against Conley. Ball, the pass to Porter. Five on the clock. Misses from close range.
They're having trouble getting going here in the second half. I mean, that's their fourth miss in five attempts.
Here's Conley. No good on the shot. And Baltimore going the other way now. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And the bruising game of Cousin, nearly impossible to match up with him given his massive size.
Baltimore shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight.
Shooting two.
And the first one at the line is good. And the Spurs making a change here. Zizic has checked in. Both free throws good from Cousins. Right around 3 minutes into the second half. Ball against Conley. Shoots over Ball. The putback controls the rebound and puts it back up and in. And the Spurs lead by two.
That is really good work there on the offensive glass.
Outside Porter. And Bell kicks to Ball. Pass to Porter. Shoots over Fournier. Porter, no luck.
I like what he was trying to do. Shaking the D with the fadeaway. Tough look.
And the three off target.
And even without that three ball dropping for him, the defense should have done more on that last play.
Ball with the bucket.
You got to admire the awareness Bogdanović possesses. I mean, solid at realizing when the D has left someone open.
Here's Conley. Following the basket by LaMelo Ball. The pass to White. He feeds it to Young. DeMarcus Cousins comes up with the rebound. Cousins has got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. And it's blocked. Well, it's out of bounds. The Barons able to retain possession here. Johnson, he's checked in for the Spurs. Baltimore with the ball. They get a hand on it. And stolen by White. Finished off the break. White's got his first 2 points of the night.
Attacking in transition, the most consistent way to generate easy looks.
Yeah, you can tell they love to get out and run when the opportunity is there.
Ball finds Cousins. Outside, Bogdanovich. Good on the three-point shot. Bogdanovich has got his third basket of the night right there.
The three-point shot is wet. Bogdanovich looking calm, cool, and collective whenever he pulls up.
And it's White missing. And so Cousins will bring it up for Baltimore. They lead by one. Good defensive work there by Young. Cousins has gone 3 of 8 shooting from the floor. Fournier goes in. Johnson a wide open look and a miss there on the triple. So it's the Barons now. A three from Bogdanovich. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball. Ball's got 6 assists now in the game. Bogdanovich has got 50% three-point field goal numbers tonight. 4 of 8. Back to Fournier. Porter pulls it in. Baltimore leading by 4. To the left side wing. Ball, the pass to Porter. It's deflected. Now here's White. Passes it to Zizic. Johnson outside. It's White on the wing. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Over Bell. Cousins pulls it in. Cousins has got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active.
His offense has been non-existent tonight. It's really hurting him.
Just using his size well close to the rim. Porter is outstanding at cashing in from those spots.
And stolen by Bogdanovich. 4-on-3 as they bring it up. On the wing, Porter. Shoots over Fournier. Porter can't get that one to fall. Spurs trail by 6. It's Fournier on the wing, guarded by Porter. And Fournier kicks to White. 5 to shoot. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. From deep. The shot, no good. And the Barons the other way now. Here's the lob to the hoop.
Oh, and the lead gets bigger on a ridiculous offensive sequence.
That dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop. San Antonio calls timeout.
They're trying to stem the tide here.
Yeah, they have to regroup it and revisit their strategy at the defensive end. Pull it back, Kobe.
Out there. We get a break in the action, so let's take a look at the West and how the teams are stacking up. You look at San Antonio, they're way down there in the conference standings, looking for a lot of improvement during the second half of the season.
And you know, for the Spurs, they talked all offseason about how this year was going to be different. Nobody bought into it then, and nobody's buying into it now.
We all know, talking the talk is easy, but carrying through, that's another story. The naysayers' predictions were basically on point.
And it's White missing.
No matter what looks they get, they just can't convert to stop this run.
No, doing anything they can to stop the bleeding, but so far, they've had no answers.
Now, here is Martin. With the teardrop, San Antonio with the rebound. Plumlee's got 4 rebounds in this game. Johnson, the pass to Plumlee. He gets it in there. Plumlee's got five.
They didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Evans against Fournier. Evans passes to Morris. And Baltimore hits again from deep.
And perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
But it had to be. These days, you need to stretch the floor somewhat to make everything else work.
Now here's Johnson. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Evans, left side. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. That's on Evan Fournier.
And you know what? Very close to a three-point play right there.
He'll take his third and fourth free throw shots of the game right here.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That's good from Evans. Greg, you know, we're seeing players take control of their free agent destiny. Do players get a bad rap for that and switching teams?
Listen, I don't know if you get a bad rap, but you're going to catch the wrath of the fan base. You think of Paul George in Indy or KD in OKC, and fans, they're going to feel jilted. There's no doubt about it. They're going to feel scorned.
Yeah.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Looking to end his cold spell, Evans with the steal. Johnson against Martin. Here's Portis. Pass to Roby. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. For Baltimore, they have gone 9 of 10 from the line, so making the most of their chances.
Taking two shots.
Shooting two.
And that one misses. And he's good on the second. And here is Johnson. No points in the game yet for him. Pass to Plumlee. DeRozan against Morris. Lock at six. Outside Fournier. From the arc. Baltimore with the rebound. Portis has got his sixth rebound on the night.
Their game plan needs to change if they're going to get out of this hole, because he is just not there offensively.
Martin with it. Now guarded by Plumlee. Martin with the bucket.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
And the 22nd pick in 2015, Bobby Portis with a nice shooting touch.
And at the same time, not afraid to mix it up, maybe to a fault. At times we've seen him get caught in the heat of the moment. You got to channel that competitive edge and stay strong mentally.
And here is Morris following Evan Fournier's three. There's 1:38 left in the third quarter. To the middle, here's Samanich, and it's blocked. Outside, Martin. A floater. Nice D from Fournier. And so it's DeRozan. He'll bring it up for the San Antonio Spurs. They trail by 11. Here's Fournier, and with that one, the lead is trimmed to single digits. Fournier's got 5 points now in the quarter. Here's Morris. 7 points in the game. There's the pass to Portis. And it's Evans in the corner. Let's it go from the wing. The rebound by the Spurs. 40 seconds left in the third. Johnson outside. Plumlee finds Johnson. Knocks it loose. Stolen by Evans. And it's Baltimore on the break. Here's Morris. But he stays with it. Outside Martin. Evans feeling it out a bit. Shot clock at 6.
First foul call. DeMar DeRozan. That's his first personal foul.
For Baltimore, they have been getting it done at the line. 10 for 12.
Mind the lane. Mind the lane. One shot.
Free throw, good, Portis.
Now, whether Portis can make the leap is still up in the air. He's young and has the potential to be really good in this league.
Just 4 to shoot. Morris passes to Cousins. And to get open is Bogdanovich. Cousins, no good. Well, through 3 quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. Barons lead by 10. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. And a chance right now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And he sliced the D wide open with this feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
No, it's quick decision making. See a guy open, you can't hesitate. That's an outstanding play right there.
Fourth quarter of action is upon us. Thanks as always for joining us. Spurs trail by 10, setting the floor for the Barons. DeMarcus Cousins out there with Bobby Portis. Then there's Monte Morris. Then there's Bogdanovich. And it's Evans in at the shooting guard. Baltimore with the ball. They've led by as many as 14 points. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and 2 shots coming up. That one on DeRozan.
I mean, even from over here, you could see that one pretty clearly.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First free throw is good. And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time. Now Conley. Out of bounds. Possession goes to the Barons. And here's the upcoming schedule for the Barons. On Thursday, the New York Knicks come to town, tipping off a homestand for them. And then on Saturday, they'll be facing Hassan Whiteside and the Toronto Raptors.
And that matchup against the Hornets, it's going to be an all-out battle. And you just hope they are rested and able to execute their game plan, as it's going to be a tremendous challenge.
Here's Conley, following the basket by DeMarcus Cousins. Passes to Šarić. Outside Conley. To DeRozan, just 5 on the clock. And it's blocked. They get it back. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. Baltimore leading by 14. Morris passes to Cousins. And it's Simonis with the rebound. And so it's San Antonio with it. Here's DeRozan, and it's blocked. But he recovers it. Sharic outside. Puts up a three. And that one is off. And the Barons the other way now. Evans outside. Let's the three fly. Sharic grabs the board. Sharic has got double-digit rebounds now in the game.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Now here's Conley. Johnson, the pass to Sharic. Kicks it to Conley. Four on the clock. Knocked away. Evans with the steal. 18 feet out. Rebounded by the Spurs. Sharic has got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. Out to the wing. Conley against Morris. Trying to get something going. Conley's shot is off.
Now look, even if he had other places to go with the ball, that's a good shot. You can't blame him for letting that one fly.
Pass to Evans. Now here's Cousins, covered by Conley. And the officials calling for a 3-second violation. San Antonio making a switch here. Young's checked in. Then for Baltimore, Porter comes in for Jacob Evans. And Ball subbed in for Morris. Spurs trail by 14. Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over.
And they just can't seem to get going offensively.
Yeah, they might be pressing a little. I mean, forcing some things. This is a good opportunity to calm everyone down.
He's checked in for Johnson. Bell is checked in for Baltimore. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
During that break, Greg Popovich really had some strong advice for his team. He is not pleased, and he told them they have to make a push right now. He said, look, we got to make a move, or I've got to pull the plug. Pretty blunt stuff, Kevin. Back to you.
Thank you, David. Ball against Conley. Oh, and there's the alley-oop. And he jams it with authority.
There's no quitting this guy. I mean, the high motor of Bell is what helps him come away with big rebounds.
Conley, the pass to DeRozan. Now here's Sharic. Young for three. Ball with the rebound.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
No good from Cousins.
It isn't the D that causes that miss. That's just a loss of concentration that time.
Young dishes to White. Porter with a block. And that one goes out of bounds. Nice touch by Porter. Over 3.5 minutes through the final quarter now. Just five to shoot. Conley the pass to Young.
And one of the things Cousins has continued to develop is defense. Really makes an effort to swat that shot away.
And hustle like that is why he leads this team in rebounds tonight.
It's all heart. He does a great job of getting after it.
Now here's Ball. Porter outside. Sharic grabs the board. Charge has got rebound number 12 now. Tenacity on the glass. DeRozan passes to Charge, and slam dunk by Charge.
And no doubt they'd love to see him get a lot more of those opportunities.
And that deficit will go away quickly if he does, Greg. Here's Ball. Cousins with it, and they double up Cousins, and we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. Baltimore with the ball. Bell passes the ball. Shot clock at 5. Here's Cousins. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball. Cousins has got the lead up to 14 now for the Barons. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Oh, and the jam by DeRozan.
And that's a display of DeRozan's athletic ability, making his presence felt on offense.
Ball, the pass to Bogdanović. DeRozan against Porter. Back to Bogdanović. No good from outside. And it's DeRozan with the ball for the San Antonio Spurs. They've given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. From about 19 feet, no good off the back of the rim.
If his performance this quarter is any indication, I don't think he's the one who's gonna let them out of the hole.
You gotta love his hustle, leaving the defense no time to react.
And how about then not settling? I mean, instead of being lazy with the shot selection, they go right to the rim.
Here's Conley following the bucket by Baltimore. And he's going up for the alley-oop. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. And Young kicks to Conley, poked loose. And the rejection by Cousins.
Shooting for San Antonio, Thaddeus Young. 2 shots.
That free throw, no good. Good on the second free throw. Now, here's Ball. Outside, Porter. And here's Bell. Kicks it out to Bogdanović. Good, and it's Cousins picking up the assist. Bogdanović has got 9 points now in just the second half. DeRozan scanning the floor. And he overshot that one, missing.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench if he keeps shooting it like that. He has been putrid here this quarter.
Cousins. And the call will be against Thaddeus Young. That'll be his second foul of the game. Evan Fournier is checked in for San Antonio.
Evan Fournier.
Here's Cousins over Šarić, and Cousins gets it to go. Cousins has got 6 points in the quarter.
Now this team is bringing the effort, and Cousins has been the difference maker. I mean, when they've given him the rock, he's used his ability to dominate.
Now, here's DeRozan. Out to Conley from outside the arc. DeMarcus Cousins comes up with the rebound. Cousins is, it's Bogdanović on the wing. And no good. And San Antonio will go the other way with it. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Here's Sharch. Out to Conley. Six to shoot. Shoots over ball. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim.
His touch has been off tonight, and now his judgment is off, too. I mean, come on. It's not a smart shot.
It's Bell, top of the key. It's Bogdanovich on the wing. DeRozan defending, and they double up Cousins. Bogdanovich wide open. Misses the three. Spurs trail by 18, and the call will be against LaMelo Ball. And that'll be his third foul so far. Charge finds DeRozan. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. Teardrop shot.
Oof, rough game offensively. He's really struggled, and really probably why they're trailing. And the pass there floated it up to the precise spot it needed to be.
And no messing around on the finish. He powers it through. Got a piece of it. Conley inside the line. Once again off the mark by San Antonio.
He's gone off the rails this quarter. And it's a bad time to do it. I mean, with their needing to fight from behind.
And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. That one on DeRozan.
And the athleticism and size of Porter creates problems for the defense. Hard to guard without getting physical.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Free throw good. Porter. Been a lot of talk, Greg, about in-season tournaments in the NBA to spur fan interest. The proposal was tabled for a bit. What are your thoughts on that?
You know, cash prizes for the players and coaching staffs. That always seems like a good idea. I just wonder, Kevin, if they're going to be any cash prizes for the broadcasters.
Because
I think they're on to something. If we could get that, you know. But in all seriousness, we see that in soccer, right? And it seems to work well. And I think if it can spur some more interest from fans, then I'd be all for it.
Yeah, the fans love it watching soccer.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
Outside ball. And the call will be against Thaddeus Young. And that'll be his third foul so far.
Yeah, clearly a foul of frustration right there.
Outside Bogdanovich. Outside Porter. Here's the three. They get it back. And that one is stuffed right through.
You can't allow Bell to get comfortable. Once he's got room near the basket, defense is toast.
And there's the pass to DeRozan. Knocks it loose. Porter kicks the ball. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
Wow. Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
A lot of talk about receding in the playoffs when you got down to the final four teams. If it ensures the two best teams make the finals, it would seem to me, Greg, to be worth it. What about you?
It could be. I think about the worldwide attention on that championship round, but you got to get the Eastern Conference teams to sign off on that. And you know, we've seen it happen in the past where the power shifts from one conference to the other. But ultimately, nothing better than seeing the two best teams play for it all.
Ball hits them both. It's been a pretty tough stretch for them.
And this will be an important possession. It's really essential they put a stop to this run, and the best way to do it is by great execution.
Now, here's Mills. Passes it to Fournier. Pocket six. Here's Jackson. Zizic passes to Mills from the wing. And Silva pulls it down.
Oh, defense, they just took that possession off. I mean, they get away with it that time, but they've got to show some more aggression.
Ball, the pass to Roby. A rebound by the Spurs.
And as we head to the final buzzer here, a crushing blowout, big-time dominance, and this will go in the record books as a gaudy win for Baltimore.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often, but tonight this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And in terms of the season record, this is going to be their 18th win overall.
No doubt they came in very motivated to win this one and finish the season series at a game apiece.
Hey, you know, guys, what a nice performance it was for DeMarcus Cousins.
And the way he rebounded, he surely was a spark for the team as he was securing everything that came off the iron.
Clemens with the bucket.
Great job of screening there. Nice job to take it to the rim and get the finish.
Pass to Mills. Back to Fournier. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. No good from Zizic.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
Here's Ball. Hits the target from 18 feet.
Saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
That's the dagger. You could tell they wanted that one. I know that seals the deal.
Fournier. Schofield grabs the board. Outside, Ball. And so it's Baltimore with the win. This one was over well before the final buzzer. The fans were waiting for something to get excited about, Greg, but they never got it.
They sure didn't. I mean, they just rolled to this win. They made it look really easy. What an efficient performance at both ends.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Chris Weber, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. So long, everyone. Thank you.